Hello everyone, and welcome to The Sims Lore. Today, we're looking at how Don Lothario might have ended up in Riverview. I believe his story is tied to the McDermotts, or at least they helped him out, so I'll be covering them as well in this video. Don't forget to subscribe and like this if you enjoyed it. Alright, let's get straight into the video. So before we get into some questions and theories, here's a bit of background about Don Lothario. I have a more in-depth video which I'll link down below, but this is just a quick recap. Don Lothario was first introduced in The Sims games in The Sims 2 Pleasant View, where he resides alone at 150 Main Street. He's known as the Casanova of Pleasant View, and he's romantically involved with his maid, Caitlin Langerac, his neighbors, the Caliente sisters, Dina and Nina, and he's engaged to Cassandra Goth. I have a video on the Goth and Caliente family as well if you're interested, I'll have them linked down below. Don is somehow involved in Bella Goth's disappearance. We know she was last seen at Don Lothario's house, and it's said that she went over to his house to welcome him to the neighborhood and was never seen again. This might not mean anything, maybe he was never involved, but it seems pretty suspicious considering that if we look at his memories, we can see he was rejected for a kiss by Bella Goth. I have a theory that Don was based on the Impertinently Curious Man story. The story, which is part of Don Quixote, is about a man named Anselmo who is convinced his wife Camilla is having an affair and got his close friend Lothario to seduce her and prove she's unfaithful. Lothario didn't want to do it, but eventually agreed, only to fall in love with Camilla. She didn't reciprocate at first, but when her husband left town to make things easier for Lothario and refused to return, she ended up falling for Lothario. The two had an affair, and Camilla's servant Leonella found out but decided to keep her secret. Leonella ends up having a secret lover of her own, but one night Lothario sees him and thinks he's Camilla's lover. He contacts Anselmo to tell him he thinks his wife Camilla is cheating. Anselmo wants to see it with his own eyes, so he tells Lothario to seduce Camilla while he hides. Before this, Camilla tells Lothario about Leonella having a lover, and Lothario comes clean about Anselmo's plan to catch her cheating, so both Camilla and Lothario plan on running away together. Camilla was actually supposed to pretend to stab herself to prove to her husband she isn't cheating, but she actually ends up stabbing herself, the crazy bitch, just to keep Lothario. Basically, Anselmo finds out, Camilla and Lothario run away and get away with it, and Anselmo dies of a broken heart. Moral of the story, don't be insecure. The story of Don and Bella could be based on all of this, Mortimer being Anselmo. I think they've taken inspiration from the story, but changed some things around, specifically around Bella Goth and her story and disappearance. Let's quickly look at Don in The Sims 3. His household bio reads, "Don woke up one morning in a whole new world. He remembers stepping onto a teleporter, several women laughing, then nothing else until he found himself here." His personal bio reads, "Don was facing a big choice between marriage and continuing to be a man about town. Will his accidental teleportation to a new town change his old ways?" Let's have a look at Don's house first. It's a small granary with three floors, and on the first floor, there's a small living room and a desk, which look kinda similar to this one from The Sims 1. Then we have the kitchen with a very cracked wallpaper, a bookshelf, and an office desk. On the second floor, there's a very small bedroom with just a bed, a rug, a painting, and a dresser. Then there's the creepy third floor, which has some kids' toys, including a dollhouse, a teddy, and a football. There's also what appears to be a social bunny painting on the wall. Don is an unemployed young adult who is flirty, hot-headed, has commitment issues, is a schmoozer, and is charismatic. His favorites are electronica music, sushi, and the color black. Compared to The Sims 2, it looks like Don learned a bit more logic and charisma skills. In The Sims 2, Don only has 2 skill points in logic and none in charisma, whereas in The Sims 3, he has 4 skill points in logic and 2 in charisma. He obviously doesn't seem to remember his relationships from Pleasant View, but he has 2 acquaintances in The Sims 3, Luke McDermott and Rhoda Bagley. So let's actually have a look at the McDermott family. They live out of 180 Bounty Drive, a farm equipped with a barn, a windmill, some vegetable gardens, and a fishing pond. The McDermott family bio reads, "The McDermotts have a way with plants. They've been growing their own food for generations, but they do try to keep up with the times. Their two young sons spend hours at the river catching fish. Will they carry on the family traditions?" Luke and Ginny McDermott live on the farm with their two kids, teen Maximus and child Travis. Luke's mother Abigail is deceased and buried in the town cemetery. You might be wondering, what do the McDermotts have to do with Don Lothario? Well, in The Sims 3 Riverview trailer, we can see that Don teleported onto the McDermott's farm, so there might be something interesting here. Let's firstly have a look at the McDermott's house. They have one living room, a kitchen, and a dining area, three bedrooms, two bathrooms, a hallway with a bookshelf and desk, and a little back garden barbecue picnic area. The McDermotts have a barn that is also a garage where they keep their second car. They also have a lot of hay and what looks like non-functional stables. We can safely assume the player is being nudged to go get the McDermotts a horse or two, which they can somewhat afford at the start of the game. Buying them a horse would mean they would have another source of income, as horses can be entered in jumping or racing competitions where cash prizes can be won. However, this is quite a bit of work that maybe Luke and Ginny can't take on. Let's take a closer look at Luke McDermott. His bio reads, "Luke McDermott spends his days in the fields raising food for his family. He likes things to be done his way. Will he be able to let go when his children want to find their own way?" Luke is an adult who loves the outdoors, can't stand art, is a perfectionist, a daredevil, and has a green thumb. His favorites are indie music, tri-tip steak, and the color green. Luke is unemployed at the start of the game, however, it's said in his bio that he works the land to raise food for his family. He is quite skilled, having 1 skill point in fishing, 7 in gardening, 1 in guitar, and 3 in handiness. His lifetime wish is to have the perfect garden, and he is good friends with both his sons Maximus and Travis, and he has a pretty good relationship with his wife Ginny. He also knows Don Lothario, but they're only acquaintances. Let's have a look at his wife Ginny. Her bio reads, "Ginny McDermott is happy to be at her husband's side in the fields. She keeps the family purse locked up tight, and she's been thinking about doing a bit of writing for extra cash." Ginny is an adult who is a little bit younger than her husband Luke, and she has no sense of humor, she loves the outdoors, is family-oriented, has a green thumb, and is frugal. Her favorites are Latin music, autumn salad, and the color lime. Ginny works part-time as a shopping music DJ in the grocery store. She has 1 skill point in fishing, 2 in writing, and 6 in gardening. Just like her husband Luke, Ginny's lifetime wish is to have the perfect garden. Ginny is good friends with both her sons Maximus and Travis, she has a pretty good relationship with her husband Luke, and is also good friends with Benny Dean, Flat Broke, and Elaine Joy. Like her bio says, she can make a bit more money by writing, as she has a good start in terms of skills and a laptop in her inventory. Financially, the family isn't doing great for its size, with only 1,500 simoleons in their household funds, so the player could consider having Ginny write when she's not at work for some extra income. And a quick side note, for those of you who think my content is reading everything from the wiki page, no, I'm not reading this off of the wiki page. I added it in. Okay, now let's look at the McDermott's children. We'll start with the elder son, Maximus. His bio reads, "Maximus McDermott has the family way with plants, but he also enjoys sports. He figures he has time to decide which he prefers. Meanwhile, he and his younger brother want to spend all their time at the river with rod and reel." Maximus is a high school student with an overall grade of B, and he has a green thumb, is athletic, lucky, and an angler. His favorites are indie music, tri-tip steak, and the color green. Maximus has 3 skill points in athletic, 2 in fishing, and 3 in gardening. He is good friends with his parents, but only acquaintances with his little brother Travis, despite his bio saying they spend all their time fishing in the river. Maximus is also acquaintances with Dallas Shallow, another teen in the neighborhood. Okay, and last but not least, Travis. His bio reads, "Travis McDermott isn't the kind of kid who spends hours with a crayon and paper. He likes the feel of the sun on his face. Travis is a B elementary school student who loves the outdoors, can't stand art, and is an angler. His favorites are Latin music, cookies, and the color lime. Travis has only one skill point in fishing. Funnily enough, the McDermotts are mentioned in the Sims 4 movie Hangout Stuff Pack in an object description for pick a peck of pennies. This reads, "While driving to pick in a neighboring state, Stephen and Checo pass through the rustic town of Riverview and take the opportunity to make cold calls. This leads them to the McDermott family, simple folk who live off the land by growing their own food and catching fish from the Simomon River. This family seems content with only having the essentials of life, but that's when Stephen spots it, a genuine Ferdinand original. Being one of the few names that carries weight beyond Riverview's borders, Stephen knew he couldn't let the opportunity to own an authentic piece from Hank Ferdinand slip away. Ginny, the matron of the family, is sharp as a whip and has a firm grip on the family wallet. She squeezes Stephen for top dollar before allowing this special piece to leave the home. So let's have a look at some of the theories. We can answer a few questions about Don and look at the McDermott's involvement in all of this. So we know the McDermott family lives at 180 Bounty Drive, and even though Don lives at 100 Bounty Drive, Don's property looks like it's on the same property as the McDermott's. Don appears to live in what used to be the McDermott's granary. Clear hints of this are the toys on the third floor of Don's house that are probably just old family toys, and the fact that Don has all of these things without being employed or working in any way. What I find interesting is that when we look at Don's relationships, he knows Luke McDermott as an acquaintance. If Luke gave him the granary, shouldn't they be closer, or at least even friends? One of my theories is that the McDermotts are either scared of Don and they stay out of each other's way, or that they aren't particularly fond of him. They might have given him somewhere to stay because of how Don mysteriously appeared on their farm. They're scared of him and think that he has some sort of power and would be able to cause them harm. Many speculate that Luke just gave Don the old granary as he had no use for it, but Don could also have had some money from relatives or on his person when he teleported on the farm. Another one of my theories about how Don got the granary is that Luke made him work on the farm for a while and gave him a place to stay. That would make more sense since Don has his gaming system and a car. Unless those came with the granary already. At first, I thought there was a slight possibility that Luke's mother, Abigail, who is buried in the Old Town Cemetery, was actually living on the family's property in the old granary. This could make sense because the McDermotts or Don couldn't really afford to deck up the old granary. If the granary wasn't being used and was empty, neither the family nor Don could really afford to put in a kitchen, bedroom, or even TV and entertainment system. Even though it's not really decked out, it still has a functioning kitchen, bathroom, and quite a bit of furniture, so it makes me wonder if Luke's mom was living here before she passed away. However, on closer inspection, this can be debunked easily by looking at the description for the granary, which reads, "Abandoned for years, the old granary stood waiting for nature to demolish it. However, recently it appears to be inhabited." And also, I can't really imagine an old woman having a gaming system, but, you know, who am I to judge? This brings me onto my next and final theory about how Don set himself up in Riverview. His other acquaintance besides Luke is Rhoda Bagley. I have a whole separate video on the Bagleys, which I'll link down below, but in short, they're a family of criminals. Don could have easily gotten involved with the Bagleys and their criminal activities and acquired a bit of simoleons to deck his place up. So how did Don end up in Riverview? We have reasons to believe he was sent there by some or all of the women who he was involved with. This clue is right in his family bio in The Sims 3. From this we can gather that he was tricked into walking on the teleporter as he remembers stepping onto it and then women laughing. Clearly, some or all of the women he was seeing found out about him cheating, tricked him to step onto the teleporter, and sent him back in time to Riverview. Another question is actually from his bio, which is, will his accidental teleportation to a new town change his old ways? And the answer to that is really up to the player. Don already has some pretty dire traits to change his ways, but it could be done. The player can decide whether he deserves to live the life he's always wanted, sleeping around and becoming a heartbreaker, or if he deserves to never achieve his lifetime wish and live a life of commitment. I honestly think the McDermotts don't have any involvement in Don's disappearance from Pleasant View, but I do think they either helped him, were scared enough to give him the old granary, or had him work the farm for it. What do you guys think about all these theories? I'd love to know in the comments below. Alright guys, there you have it, lots of info on why Don is in Riverview and the McDermott family. I'd love to know how you play with both households, so let me know in the comments below. I'd like to thank my patrons, Olivia McSwain, Negative Dana, Papa Khan, Leo Thompson, Artsy Flashback, Nathan Lim, Caitlin Luigi, Nicole Dante, Mr. Netch, A Wild Kitty Cat, and Shanique. Thank you guys so much for supporting my channel. That's it for today's video, thank you all so much for watching, please like the video if you enjoyed it, and let me know your theories in the comments below. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram for more lore and updates. I'll see you in my next video, bye!